Everything in this house has been done on purpose to make sure that the energy consumption is as low as possible. First thing is the orientation of the home. That's the first thing we think about when we talk about passive design is where's the sun and how are we going to get that into the house? The second thing is the glazing. So the weakest point in any building or dwelling is the glazing. So you need to make sure that you've got high quality glazing. The third thing is the insulation. Having a super insulated structure is really important. And the fourth thing is the slab and the thermal mass. Those four things have really worked together to create the high star rating in this home. One thing that we were pleasantly surprised with was the level of airtightness. When we tested this house, we were aiming for a really, really low number. It was high levels of supervision to make sure that there was an airtight structure. But when we actually did the test, it was really nice to see that, you know, come to fruition. Iteratively. So we started using the software as soon as we had a floor plan, and then as we went along, we would continue to go back and forth between the designing software and the NatHERS software. So it was a constant back and forth process. We see a lot of designs once they're already complete across our desk. And at that point, there's very little scope to change the design, to change the materials, to change the wall construction. So if you get that design in the software early, you know, an architect has got a chance to talk with their client to make sure that the client is fully on board, understands where the energy levels are at of their design. Because by the time you get to the end, the client's fallen in love with the design and they don't want to change it. And then they're stuck with it. So if you can get in front of an energy assessor or a consultant at the start, then you've got a much better chance of getting a really good outcome, or a much better outcome. So what a lot of people don't understand or know about energy efficiency compliance when it comes to getting their certificate for their building code compliance is that the six star rating isn't the only way that you can achieve compliance. There are other pathways where you can to get your certificate. So the thermal modelling element of a NatHERS assessment means that you can get heating and cooling loads zone by zone. So in a house like this, you can get an indication of which room is going to be the hottest and which room is going to be the coldest. If you're going through one of the other ways of getting through the building code, you don't get that feedback. It's merely a tick box system, and you don't get that sort of, I guess, intelligence. Bang for buck. Well, as I mentioned earlier, the windows are the biggest weak point in a building, but they're usually quite expensive if you're going to go for higher quality glazing. So bang for buck, I would say insulation, continuous insulation, and lots of it, especially in this climate. So the NatHERS software models a standard four-person family, and it makes all sorts of assumptions about when the house is going to be occupied, when the windows are going to be open, when the occupants are going to put a jumper on. It makes all sorts of assumptions about how that family is going to live. The people who live in the house really have to understand how the house needs to be operated or sailed. So if you put a person in a home like this who doesn't understand how to operate it, you're not going to get the most out of it. The people who live in a house like this really need to understand what the features are, what they mean, and the purpose behind it. Well, there's two things that I can think of off the top of my head. One is knowledge of how to get an energy efficient home. People don't know where to start looking or who to ask. And the other thing, I think the perception is that anything to do with energy efficiency or high performance is perceived to be higher cost as well. And that is not the case. It's not necessarily the case if you get in early and design it into the house from the start.